They've all heard countless of consultants and that one YouTuber who hasn't studied in France promoting France as a study destination because France is considered to have the largest number of triple accredited business schools. Now you and I can agree that if given a choice between choosing a triple accredited business school or a business school which is not triple accredited, you would prefer choosing a triple accredited business school, correct? Well, if you agree with me, hit the like button so that I know you agree with me. If you don't prefer choosing a triple accredited business school to study in France, please comment down below so that I know why you wouldn't choose a triple accredited business school, and the comments will obviously help others who are watching this video. But here's my question. If you have agreed that you would prefer studying in a triple accredited business school this year, I can't understand why 80% of the students who have actually taken an appointment with me this year are planning to study in a school which has lost their triple accredited status, when rather for the same amount of money you can actually study, or they can actually study, in a triple accredited business school. I'm not actually going to mention the schools which have lost their triple accreditation status, but there are two schools in France this year which have lost their triple accreditation status. I'm actually going to ask you to click on the link below in the description to find out who. Once you go to the link, you can actually just type Ctrl+F, type lost, and you will actually come to a tab which says schools which have lost the accreditation status. Now, if you're also a student who's planning to study in France this year or the following intake, I'd also recommend that you click on the same link to find out if schools you're choosing are actually triple accredited or not. Now, after reading this link, you're going to be like, bro, this is not a reliable resource, or this is not a reliable source. Well, in that case, I'm actually going to ask you to go and check the schools website, the schools which I mentioned who have lost their triple accreditation status. Go to their website and check out if they have the three triple accreditations on their website. The three triple accreditations are ECOS, AMBA, AACSB. Normally, all schools are supposed to put out the accreditations on their website. So you can actually double check if you think my source is not reliable on their website to see if they have all three of these accreditations. Now, after mentioning this, a lot of people don't believe me. So then I asked them to send an email to the management to ask if they have the triple accreditation or if they've lost the triple accreditations. Now, the problem in this is you could send an email, but they're not going to reply. But to understand why they will not reply now is you will have to watch my next video. If they do reply, they're going to say that yes, they have lost their triple accreditation. They're not going to mention they lost it, but they're going to tell you that they stopped renewing one accreditation status and they're actually applying for another accreditation status and they are actually still multi-accredited. Good wordplay, schools. I've actually been to a webinar which they host to recruit future students. And in these webinars, it's very interesting. Previously, when they had the accreditations, they would proudly say they're triple accredited, but now they actually just go and say that they're multi-accredited. And if you're not aware about the triple accreditations, I wouldn't blame you if you assume that they're still triple accredited. There is a large number of Indian students who are currently studying at the school or who have recently graduated from the school. And the saddest part is none of them know that this school or their school has actually lost their triple accreditation status. I can't help but assume that the school, which took pride in actually mentioning to you or future students or students who are currently in the school that they were triple accredited and they should be chosen over other schools, not mentioning it to their students when they actually lost their triple accreditation status. I mean, why would they? It's bad for business, and technically it's bad for the future prospective students to know this, because if you didn't know, international students are major cash cows for business schools abroad. See, this is not my problem, and I don't have any problem with the schools mentioned on the list. I only hope that this video will help you make a better decision when you're planning to study abroad. See, your consultant or that one YouTuber who is not studied in France but is promoting France as a study destination has no reason to mention this particular fact to you or this particular information to you, because it's bad for all of their businesses. So you might be wondering, why is this guy who actually lost his APA status from another school talking about schools which have lost their triple accreditation status? But maybe it's me, and I think it's the same for you. But if I actually paid a large amount of money, a large amount of my parents' money, to study in a school which I assume is triple accredited, and I assume that I'm going to graduate from a triple accredited school, I'd expect to graduate from one too. Forget graduating from the business school. Like, I'd expect that after paying such large amounts of money and expecting to graduate from a triple accredited business school, I'd expect the business school to at least have the least amount of decency to let me know when they've lost their triple accreditation status, instead of being blindsided by a random YouTuber called The Lost Indian. If there is one thing you can actually take away from today's video, it is always do your research. You're spending a lot of money, probably it's your parents' hard-earned money, and I ask you to actually spend it wisely and do your research to find your best possible choices. Furthermore, if you would actually like to talk to me, or you would actually like to receive some unbiased guidance, feel free to schedule an appointment with me. Please do not message me on Instagram, because there's way too many people to message on Instagram and I keep losing out on a lot of you. If you don't want to be lost out on, feel free to take an appointment. Moreover, if you actually find out the name of the schools, again by clicking on the link which I put down below, and you find out that you have a friend studying there, or you have a friend who's possibly thinking of studying there, feel free to share this video with them so that they are aware that they can have better choices rather than going to schools which have lost their triple accreditation status. Well, this was a very heavy video to make. I'm not very proud of this video, but I can't help feeling sad for all my friends who are studying in the schools, who actually paid to study in a triple accredited school, paid to graduate and expect to graduate from a triple accredited school, and now they're probably not going to. And the reason I make these videos is in the hope that all of you, while watching this or after watching this, will make better decisions. Moreover, the objective I have for this video is that I hope that schools who are watching this, and I know a lot of schools watch my videos, that all we ask is for a little transparency in your communication with us, right? We are paying a lot of money and that's the least we could expect. I'd also recommend that you subscribe to this channel for more value bombs like this. Like, there's a lot of videos, there's a lot of information which I wish you knew, but I'm slowly going to put it in videos. Well, thank you for watching. That's it for today. I'll see you next video.